teachers call him disobedient. His classmates call him outright. His college seniors call him impolite. But none of that matters to him. Being a spoiled rich kid could have also contributed to the way Azhar is viewed by others. But that stops right there. One could not say he was a bad person, but he certainly didn't make a good first impression. Azhar didn't particularly care for anyone, but he specifically disliked four of his fellow classmates. They continuously made trouble and were rude to everyone, which irritated him to the point where he openly expressed his dislike for them. With high hopes and innocent ambitions, Boaz enters his college to start his very first day. Naturally, he feels overwhelmed with complex emotions and feelings. But unfortunately for him, he fell into the nasty and dangerous trap of bullying. However, not everyone stays quiet. Despite being too self-absorbed to care for others, as everyone says, Azhar steps in to stop those terrible and insecure bullies from abusing poor Boaz even further. They say every cloud has a silver lining. In this case, the silver lining is the start of a beautiful friendship between Azhar and Boaz. The next day, Azhar took Boaz to a party to relax their minds. This was a new experience for Boaz. However, he enjoyed it very much. Suddenly, Azhar took out a packet of substance from his pockets and starts to consume it. Boaz gets surprised, but he doesn't stop him from doing the deed. However, the said silver lining doesn't last long. Boaz quickly picks up his things and rushes to his hostel, which is probably his one place of solitude and peace. While walking back, he feels paranoid that his bullies might be back soon to trouble him. But he pushes further and retreats to his room. With worry and stress filling his mind, he starts to sob out of frustration. He decides that the best way to end his suffering is to end his life at a whole. But he stumbles upon something. Something that is one and only friend left in his room. Something that makes you lose your composure and possibly make you forget about your troubles temporarily. The pleasure that Boaz had tasted once is not enough for him. He starts to earn more and more for ecstasy, that he resorts to unfair and illegal means to obtain the said substance. The innocence in him slowly fading away and replaced by remorse and desire. However, this doesn't go unnoticed by Azar, who checks up on him as a true friend he is. But when he does, things take a turn for the worse. Azar receives immediate medical attention. Luckily, his injuries are not life-threatening. The doctor advises him to take plenty of rest and medication to cure him faster. Boaz comes to visit his injured friend, but Azar, out of anger, doesn't want to see his face, which makes him very sad. Boaz returns to class a few days later and the bullies start to resume their routine of bullying him. But Boaz instead does something unexpected.
I don't know.